And then when someone does disrupt, they have a speaker to stand up for Robe and say, we ask that you stop speaking, just so they can talk over him, you see, so that their question can't be heard. And so Karl Rove takes a break, and they say, we ask that you stop speaking. You'll be removed from the university. I've seen this at the Petraeus speeches and other Rove speeches. It's really a control tactic.
And let's be clear. He was done with his speech, and they were saying, we're now going to go to these cue cards.
Yeah, I mean, his speech was so boring, I didn't think it would be worthwhile to interrupt it. The only reason I did interrupt at all is because there was no free speech. You had to be a pre-written cue card, Republican or Democrat. I'm not that. But yes, I waited till he said, thank you, indicating the end of his speech after he wrapped it up and said, you know, Obama's not so bad after all, since he continues that war, those wars, rather.
Really?
Oh, yeah, he gives Obama credit. He says, you can see, even though it's not what he campaigned on, it's reflected in the polls. People love that he's continuing the war, basically, is the essence of
it. Yeah, he has the lowest approval rating of any president a year and a half in.
As long as he continues the war, he's not so bad.
I mean, Karl Rove is such a duplicitous liar. Let's go ahead and go to this video. Here it is.
...ism and extremism. And the president is right to move it. Thanks for having me here today. I'm now going to bring up the questioners.
You talk about free speech, but I'm not a Democrat or a Republican.
Shut up and sit down.
Are you going to take my question? Take my question. I have a question.
You're gone, but let me talk to the next.
You're a liar. The Iraq war, the blood is on your hands. Don't grab me. Don't touch me.
These guys are going to ask the question.
We're tired of your skull and bones narco trafficking. Get your hands off me. Get your hands off me.
Listen. Come on.
I am not resisting.
We're going to do is turn left.
I am not resisting.
Yeah.
I am not resisting.
Very good. Thank you.
If you want me to leave the building, that is fine. I'm more than happy to leave the building.
You're under arrest. Stay.
I'm not resisting arrest.
I do not need to let you in here. I'm here.
Sir, I have a right to free speech. You have no reason to arrest me. Why am I being arrested?
You are under arrest.
What is the reason?
Disruption of a lawful assembly.
Are you going to read my Miranda rights?
I'm not asking you incriminating questions. There's a guy trying to get in behind us.
How long did this go till they turn the camera off?
Camera off in 5 minutes or so. Once they did the initial handcuffing.
Keep rolling in here. Going into the dungeon.
You're not
going
to like it if I sue you personally for violating my rights of free speech.
You going to do this room, sir?
Okay. Here's all the other criminals.
I think that was Jacobson for 1 second.
Oh, so that's when it got turned off.
I guess so, yeah.
They grabbed it away from you?
They took it from me when they put me in cuffs, so.
And there's Rob in there. Oh, man, I tell you.
I mean, they were silencing free speech very skillfully. Rove is skillful. I mean, I wish I could come off articulately. He knows how to handle all these questions. He's an old Watergate dirty trickster. That's when he...
And he tripled the size of government. He supported the assault weapons ban. He got Bush to support carbon taxes. And the Republicans are just a bunch of idiots. They wonder why they're losing their country. They wonder why everything's falling apart. They go in there, these milquetoast, weak-looking people, and just look up at him like a dog looks at its master, just lovingly. Oh, we love you, Rove. We love criminality. We love it all. We love Bohemian Grove. We love the gay orgies. It's conservative.
It's sick. It's not our everyday point, but the way they control politics on college campuses, you know, is the embryo of the weak party system we have today that makes things so bad.
Well, Karl Rove, you know, he likes all those midnight visits that came out in the news.
You know, that's neither here nor there, I guess.
It's all just a big, but he's conservative, though. That's good.
Mm.
And, you know, it's good that Newt Gingrich is supporting carbon taxes. You're some kind of commie. You're against taxes, boy.
It's sick. I mean, we know how the Constitution should put us, but we're not there.
Anything else, Aaron, you'd like to add about this fiasco?
It was a long night. I'm glad it's over. I really didn't want to get arrested, but sometimes it has to be done.
Well, I mean, in the old days, I guess I've got to start going to these. I would get up and, you know, ask questions of Reno and other people and Barry McCaffrey and others, and they didn't arrest me.
I'll say one thing about Rove. I've been through a lot of hairy confrontations working for you over the years. This is the first time I've been arrested formally in cuffs with charges. So Bilderberg would be the second.
And you've had armed security guards of the Federal Reserve a half mile away come to a city park and tell you turn a camera off or they're going to arrest you and start handling their guns.
Well, yeah, we've been through some adventures, and that's the world out there. Someone has to stand up, Alex. I mean, we weren't born to be in some prostrate position. At some point, someone has to stand up. I wish it was someone more articulate than me.
But I thought you worked for a right-wing pro-war guy, the liberal media says, but we're out asking questions against the war, which the Democrats don't do anymore. You notice now it's their war, and they like it, and they like the torture, and they've just shut up. Aaron Dykes, good job. Go home and get some sleep, buddy.
Thanks, man.
Great job. All right, we'll be back with more news, and we've got Dr. Bob Bowman coming up. Stay with us.